Davy Jones, the heartthrob of a generation.
When you look at people who were television heartthrobs who also happened, Davy Jones is always going to be top 10.
And Jones is survived by his wife, Jessica, and four daughters, and our thoughts are certainly with them today. Anne?
All right, Natalie, thank you. Micky Dolenz is one of the original members of the Monkees and a longtime friend of Davy Jones. Good morning, Micky. It's an emotional morning. Pretty tough day.
Yeah. It came a pretty big shocker.
Yeah.
Yeah, right out of the blue.
Mm.
You know, he was the last one that I thought would, you know, he was the youngest one of us, you know, and I suspect a little bit it might have been the genetics. You know, I think both his parents passed pretty early on.
His mother died when he was very young. People don't realize he quit school. He actually dropped out of school when that happened.
Father passed away also, I believe, with a heart attack, and when he wasn't very old either.
And yet he always seemed on camera, Micky, as this cup half full guy. Is that what he was in real life?
Yeah, I mean, he was always the go-to guy for fun and for a laugh, and he never took himself or any of us. We never took ourselves very seriously. You couldn't, you know. He was, a jokester, and always was, and we hung out a lot together. I remember him very clearly because we had similar backgrounds. And even in the very early auditions, and the auditions went on for a long, long time. But even in the early auditions, I remember that we kind of connected because I'd been in showbiz as a kid doing a series called Circus Boy. And he'd been on stage doing Oliver. So we had that kind of connection in common. And so immediately we just kind of hit it off and stayed very good friends. Then our families got together and we started and had kids at about the same time. And so he and I used to hang out an awful lot.
You both had performed before. I think a lot of people don't realize he actually was nominated for a Tony for his work on Broadway.
On Oliver, yeah.
Yep, that's right. And you
performed
know,
on the show the Beatles were on.
That's right. When the Beatles
Sullivan
first
show.
The first time when they came to perform on that show. On his website, he once recalled these auditions that you just talked about, and he said when the four of you were put together, someone said, "That's it. It's magic." What was the magic that the four of you had? How would you describe this relationship?
If I could describe it, I'd do it again with other people. It's that serendipitous sort of thing that catching lightning in a bottle. I don't think you can, there's no formula, but you get lucky and certain people get together and that chemistry happens and it's like a little bit of magic, and it did certainly happen with us. It's down a little bit to the producers identifying and recognizing the talent. You know, in the case of the Monkees, it was the show about this imaginary group, and it was a sitcom, essentially, about this out-of-work group. So they were looking for four different character types, much like the Marx Brothers. And we actually screened Marx Brothers movies when we were working on the show, because they wanted there to be a big difference in the comedy, and there certainly was. You know, we didn't step on each other's toes comedy-wise.
Yeah, it was fun, just fun to watch the four of you.
Yeah.
So now, on this morning, how will you best remember, what will you remember most about Davy Jones?
I keep going back to just watching him play soccer, kicking around a soccer ball on a... We used to have a private plane on tour, and we would land at an airport, and a private airport where we were going to go play a gig, and or getting back on the plane. And I, for some reason, the images come back to me of him and a bunch of other guys running around the grass around the plane, kicking a soccer ball. That's one of them that comes to mind, or hanging out swimming in the pool or something like that, you know.
Yeah, basically moments of fun and relaxation.
Because ultimately, you know, we all became pretty good friends, and he and I probably the best of friends.
Well, you are a very good friend on the morning of having lost such a good friend, to stand up for him this morning on national television, Micky Dolenz.
He's a great guy, a lovely man, great father, you know, great kids. Sad.
Thank you. And now we're going to get it.